This is the Alienware AW2725Q, a stunning 27-inch 4K QD OLED monitor that aims to deliver otherworldly experiences. While this is not a cheap monitor by any stretch, what if I told you this monitor keeps things trim, including the price, at least comparatively? Well, we're gonna tell you all about this right here, right now on Robeytech. I'm just gonna get this out of the way. We love OLEDs, and if you've experienced them, then you probably do too. We love the HDR brightness, the color reproduction, and the growing ease of care with every new generation of panels. In short, the OLED experience is just awesome. And what's even better is that we're just seeing more and more options hit the market from companies like MSI, Asus, and Samsung. But let's not forget whose OLED brought us here today. When Dell offered us the opportunity to check out the new Alienware AW2725Q gaming monitor, what do you think we said? Well, of course we said yes. And this isn't just a carbon copy of Alienware monitors of the past. This thing's AW30 design celebrates 30 years of Alienware products with a new glyph design, updated UI, and more. So we're gonna take a look at the AW2725Q to talk about what it is, what it can do, and if it might be the right monitor for you. Also, as we get rolling, we wanna say a huge thank you to Dell for letting us borrow the monitor for this review. And yes, for the sake of my sanity, we'll be calling the AW2725Q the monitor for the rest of the review. Starting with the price at the time of this video, the monitor retailed for just under $900. And yes, I know that is expensive, especially when you consider that there are 32-inch OLEDs for the same price. However, when we compare it to the new 27-inch OLEDs from Asus and MSI, the monitor is actually a bit more cost conscious, which is actually pretty awesome. The big question is whether its features can make it stand out or if the ones it omits make it less valuable for you. And honestly, that really depends on you. So let's talk about the specs and features. As we mentioned in the intro, this is a 27-inch QD OLED monitor with a 4K or UHD resolution. This form factor for OLEDs is growing in availability, and it's great for anyone who wants to move to an OLED but isn't quite ready to jump to a 32-inch display because of size or competitiveness, or they just don't have the desk space. The monitor has a 240 Hertz refresh rate with a certified NVIDIA G-Sync compatibility, AMD FreeSync Premium Pro, and VESA Adaptive Sync 240 certifications. So you have options when it comes to variable refresh rate. And quite honestly, when we were testing the monitor out, it was super smooth, and we'll talk about that more in a second. On top of that, the monitor has both Dolby Vision and VESA DisplayHDR True Black 400 modes, which both offer incredible depth of color, especially when you're looking at scenes with contrasting bright and dark areas. It also helps that the monitor has a pixel density of 166 pixels per inch, which is amazing for on-screen text, a 0.03 millisecond gray-to-gray response time, a delta E less than 2 color accuracy, and around 99% of the DCI-P3 color gamut. So what this means for users is that the monitor's color and contrast range produces incredible visual fidelity. And with its preset color profiles, as well as the flexibility to tweak it to your liking, we were impressed by the quality of the monitor's output and ability to be customized. Truth be told, the visual fidelity matched the Asus ROG Swift 32U CDP, which you can actually check out the review of right here, and it was one of our favorite monitors we've reviewed so far this year. Stats are one thing, but from an experience standpoint, gaming on this thing was as much of a treat as the 32U CDP. Out of the box, the color profiles were similar, so games like Destiny 2, Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, and Cyberpunk 2077 all looked absolutely fantastic. Not to mention that the motion blur, if there was any, was imperceptible, thanks to the high refresh rate and variable refresh rate options. Color is one thing, but when we looked at the ISO monitor test, color uniformity was great, text clarity was stellar, and gradients were on point. It was really wild to put the monitor side by side with the UCDP and seeing that out of the box, it was nearly a one-to-one experience. And if you've been around, you know how much we love that monitor. So depending on who you are and what you're looking to do with this monitor, you might actually like the size of this monitor better. Moving on to connectivity, the monitor has two HDMI 2.1 ports, one DisplayPort 1.4 port, three USB Type-A ports, one USB Type-C port with 15-watt power delivery, and one upstream USB 3.2 Type-B port. Now, there are a few things to point out here though. For starters, the first HDMI port is eARC equipped. This means that if you have an ARC or eARC enabled soundbar like the Sonos ARC Ultra or the Creative Labs Katana V2, you can run HDMI from your PC or console to your soundbar and then to the monitor for Dolby Atmos enhanced surround. This is a super handy addition if you make use of it, but there are a few omissions here that Alienware made to keep costs down. For starters, you may have noticed that the DisplayPort is a version 1.4 port, which isn't uncommon, but but it's not the DisplayPort 2.1 found in the new Asus ROG Swift OLED PG27U CDM and the MSI 272 URX monitors. Even so, this monitor has DisplayPort compression, so it can play in DisplayPort 2.1's backyard when it comes to support for high refresh rate at higher resolutions without the expense of actually living there. While we're on topic of DisplayPort, the USB-C connection is purely for USB-C devices, so be aware it doesn't support DisplayPort over USB-C, and because this is a typical USB-C connection, not an upstream connection, this monitor does not offer KVM support. So no sharing monitor, keyboards, and mouse between devices. Now we realize these two things are super niche, but it could be a bummer for a handful of Mac users who are hoping to use this as a second display for their iMacs or for those who keep a Mac Mini on their desktops. Like we said, there are some hits and misses here, but it's very user specific. But let's say you're hearing all this and you're liking what you're hearing, but you're wondering what the monitor comes with or if it would fit on your desk. Starting with what's in the box, the monitor comes with the QD OLED panel, a monitor stand and base alongside HDMI, DisplayPort, and USB Type-A to Type-B cables. It's got a power cable, a microfiber cloth, a QR card for quick reference, and an Alienware sticker, which is great for people who love stickers. For dimensions, the monitor is 24 inches wide, a bit over 20 inches tall, and a little over 8 inches deep with the stand attached. If you're looking to use a monitor arm or a wall mount, the monitor does support VESA 100x100 mounts, so the dimensions of the panel itself are around 14 inches tall and a little under 3 inches deep. And since the horizontal dimension isn't impacted here, it's still 24 inches wide. You know what else isn't impacted by monitor stand's presence? Liking, subscribing, and ringing those notification bells here at Robeytech and Robeytech Live. But come to think of it, I do believe that viewers that do those things tend to walk just a little bit taller. Now moving on to weight, the monitor weighs just under 15 pounds or around 6.8 kilograms assembled. Without the stand, the panel itself only weighs around 9.5 pounds or 4.3 kilograms. As for assembly, it's super straightforward and toolless if you're using the stand. The base secures to the stand with a bolt you can tighten by hand, and the stand clips into a recess on the back. If you're using a VESA mount, the mounting points are inside of the recess cavity. We actually did assemble it both ways for a desktop and for a monitor arm. Both were incredibly simple. And before we move on, can we just pause to appreciate just how beautiful the design is? I know that some people give Alienware guff over their design language, but this thing is stunning with its matte midnight blue aesthetic that Alienware calls interstellar indigo. It's also got like a super smart cable management channel, and the small footprint of the base is actually really nice. Oh, and how can we forget the RGB? We were actually surprised by how subtle the RGB accents are on the monitor in comparison to other Alienware devices we've seen in the past. It has the iconic Alienware logo on the back, as well as a power button that's RGB that can be changed with the on-screen display or with Alienware's command center software. I know that design is subjective, but this is one well-built and sexy monitor. Now, since we're on topic, let's talk about Alienware's support software. We mentioned Alienware's command center software does offer RGB control, but it does way more than that. What's also cool is that you don't necessarily need a USB connection to use ACC. You can control it via DisplayPort or via HDMI. Within Alienware's control center, you can monitor system info, edit monitor settings, create custom presets, and more. Aside from all the typical visual adjustments, there are also features like picture-in-picture and picture-by-picture, as well as the ability to add a crosshair to the screen. As an aside, if you're someone who actually uses features like crosshair on a gaming monitor, I would really like to know in the comments, because I have yet to find someone. Essentially, Alienware Command Center is an alternative if you don't want to mess with the OSD. But honestly, we found the OSD to be easy enough with the navigation stick and with how cleanly it's actually laid out. Now, if you've watched our other monitor videos, especially on OLEDs, you might be asking, Robey, what about a warranty? What about OLED burn-in? Can I even trust myself with a monitor as awesome as this? To that, I'd say, settle down, it's actually gonna be okay. The monitor comes with a 3-year warranty that covers OLED burn-in as well as dead pixel protection. On top of that, if the monitor needs to be replaced, Dell's included advanced exchange service provides next business day shipping for the actual replacement, which is pretty cool. If that isn't enough peace of mind, Alienware does offer a 3-year advanced care option for around $77 that offers 24-hour tech support. This does feel a little bit weird to have like a second tier of support for a monitor, but it might be a value add if you're really concerned about needing help with your monitor. And if that's you, Dell has it available for you. Outside of the warranty, the monitor does have a pixel refresh feature to help keep it in tip-top shape. This feature will prompt users to run pixel refresh every 4 hours of use, and the process takes between 6 to 8 minutes to complete. So if the monitor is a daily driver device for you during your workday, the prompt may just let you know it's time to take a lunch break. On top of that, the monitor is designed with a graphite sheet that acts as a heat spreader to help protect the screen, as well as an active cooling system to keep the internal components breezy. Now you might hear that and wonder about this monitor and the noise. And to that I'd say, don't worry, it really isn't noticeable, especially if you're running it right near your PC. Okay, so we've shared a ton of information about the monitor and sprinkled in some experiences along the way, but now we have to ask the big question. Is the Alienware AW2725Q worthy of becoming your next gaming monitor? As things stand right now, the monitor falls into an interesting space. Of the new 27-inch OLED monitors to hit the market, this is by far the least expensive, but it cuts out some features that may or may not make it a better value for you. Let's start with some considerations. If you're someone who relies on sharing your monitor, keyboard, and mouse through a single display, or you need support for DisplayPort over USB-C, the absence of these features takes a bit of value away from you. If you're someone who's spending RTX 5090 money and you're worried about driving 4K frame rates above 240 frames per second with multi-frame generation, the reality is there really aren't many 4K OLEDs on the market right now taking advantage of DisplayPort 2.1. And let's be clear, this does have a 240 hertz refresh rate at 4K, and you're gonna have a great experience with it. But you have to decide if getting a monitor that is capable of a higher refresh rate signal is of value to you. That being said, for most users, the features that are being omitted to keep the cost down below the competition while still maintaining features that matter, features like high refresh rates, high pixel density, eARC for Dolby Atmos sound, G-Sync and FreeSync Premium Pro, the list goes on. That's just gonna be up to you. Not only that, the compact footprint of the stand helps save desktop space, and the new AW30 design takes Alienware's unique design language and adds an industrial flair to it. Overall, there is actually a lot to be impressed with here, but $900 is still $900. At the moment though, this is still one of the least expensive 27-inch QD OLEDs on the market. But you have to decide if Alienware made the right choices with the features it trimmed or not, and whether those cuts would actually save you money or cost you with what you needed in the long run. But for most of you, the answer is probably no, and you're going to really love this monitor. And with that, we're gonna wrap this one up. We wanna say thank you again to Alienware for giving us some time with the AW2725Q for this review, but we wanna know what you think. Are any of the features missing from this monitor a deal breaker for you? And again, are you someone who uses built-in monitor features like crosshairs or picture-in-picture? Let us know all those down in the comments below. And now while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. And if you wanna continue the conversation, talk about the questions we ask in these videos, or ask questions of your own, head on over to our Discord server. That's discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff like this. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us at Robeytech on all your other favorite social media platforms. And if you made it this far, thank you so much for sticking with me throughout this video, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one.